Nice to see you.
We did quite a bit of deliberation about that opening sequence there. How'd it go? Pretty good. You swept away at the moment.
Less defeat.
Mr. Tillman, good to see you again. There's a few outstanding troubles just before we check you in to see you. You left your passport in the really fridge and a message in the desk. See, the picture isn't just a reminder that I'm not the same. Don't leave your mattress in the rain. You sleep on the balcony. I'm feeling
element of downtown. I'm great to see the sun. Benefit more than I should have been from the months from you. This there, this how does it feel supposed to address your shop with anybody's guess alone. You can call me Macy.
Oh my God. Thank you very much. Jesus, what do you make of this? You're living in New York. You're doing it. You need some water. You're not, tell me you're not consuming seed oils. Okay, up front here has lost a pet recently. What was their name? Pomone and Casey. French bulldogs. You strike me as a large reptile. Wait. No, Pomone and Casey. Pomone. Okay, that's better. Pomone and Casey. I recently lost a fictional cat. So, we're going to send this one out to your French bulldogs, Pomone and Casey. This may be the last time I put on my shoe. Go down to the corner, buy the day at the expense of food. Started making signs that say, "Don't the last time come too soon." One down ain't to go, but it's the last time. Don't the last time come too soon. This may be the last time I get out of bed. Put coffee on, try to get your words to show some initiative. We used to lay around here laughing, what these freaks out there were trying. But what's wasting time if not throwing it away on the world when the last time comes so soon? Mr. Blue Daddy Mountain, don't the last time come too soon. Love's always come to leave you, no matter what they say. You only know what it is once it's gone away. This may be the last time I lay here with you.
not the cat. You don't have to answer that, I'll just make do. But maybe he'd gone soon and could have brought us back together last June. When the last time was our last time, if only then I knew. The last time was our last time, would have told you that the last time comes.
I'd like to send this next one out to all my famous people out there. We see you. The room your captive baby starts to fill with gut-busting laughter. You're transformed into a five-foot laughter. Funny girl, your schedule's pretty crazy. Doing interviews for the new live-action Kathy. Could you pencil in an industry outsider? Yeah, you're young, but baby, you're not getting young, girl. Let me lead you to your seat like me. Anybody else have a bunch of kind of demented fake jazz music to show for their time in lockdown? Just me, huh? That's good. All right, let's carry on.
Thank you.
after Mr. and Mrs. finished dinner in his shoe. Now the fish is definition so much higher than it was last year. It's like the images of all the careers, almost living my life for me out of the meal. Plugged into our home, skin and bones, a frozen smile on every face, as the stories reflect, this must have been a wonderful place. Blue. Look out, buddy, no one's living it up.
Thank you.
I swore I wouldn't do this. Wine's gone to my head. The fake man's been strapped in. Stay with me tonight instead. The end will not be followed. Sky will not descend. Life can be more sweet than bitter. If you're alone, let me in. Kiss me.
Is anybody familiar with Jack Bruce? Can you see Jack Bruce? I discovered his music through the, I think he worked with David Lynch on something. Something called What Did Jack Do? That was something that I watched. Turns out I had some time on my hands in 2020. Watched a lot of stuff, and was pretty uninspired, and I saw the same monkey in this movie, and I just thought, that's me. That's what I do. And he sang this song in the movie called True Love's Flame, and yeah, it was just really, it just got me off my ass and writing songs, right? This stuff we're playing tonight. And when we were done, I thought, man, it would be really great be really full circle if I could get Jack Cruz to cover that song that just did Kiss Me, because it had been kind of inspired in the first place. So we threw, I wrote an email and said, well, we got an email. I mean, I know a lot of people in the music industry, right? And I just could not get a lion on this guy, on this monkey. Nobody knew him. So the closest that we could get to somebody that knew him was David Lynch. I'm telling you, the only person. So I wrote an email and said, dear David, hi, I appreciate it if you could pass this song. It really inspired us. Great, if you can sing the tune. And 6 weeks went by. I got an email from his manager, David Lynch, who goes, Josh, great to hear from you. I have no idea where Jack is. Last I heard, he was living in Guatemala. He does not have any kind of papers to get back into the country. Keeps sending in money. I'm sure he was drinking it away. Very sorry, but I can't. This is the best email anyone's ever gotten. I was happy to just let it. If it was just that, I would have been very happy. A few weeks later, I get another email from David, Jack Cruz's manager, saying, Josh, good news. I just heard from Jack. He's in Las Vegas. He's trying to get his computer back, but he's living with a prostitute. I know that he can go get his phone charged at the Jacket Box. So there's a chance we might be able to reach him. This goes on and on and on for months. Never quite committed until finally, he let me know that Jack was going to be in the Los Angeles area, and that the song, to everyone's surprise, seemed to have really moved him, and that he was willing to record it, to come out of retirement and record this song. And I said, great, when's the session? You know, he's like, you absolutely cannot come to the session. And I just want to say that finding management like that for someone who's been treated the way that I've been treated, I'm fine. Anyway, I don't really know how to stick the landing of this story. It's not one I generally tell, but. I will say that I signed a contract that was bigger than all of my album contracts combined in terms of about how I am allowed to talk about this episode. But I'm not going to finish this story by telling you that the 7-inch is for sale at the merch table. But thank you, David. Thank you, Jack Cruz. Thanks, New York. Thanks for
Yeah.
Where are we? Yeah, I mean, it is very surreal to be playing this music for you. It was never intended to leave the studio because it was made at a time when seemed pretty certain that touring music was going to be a thing of the past. So I set out to make something kind of categorically untourable. Yet here we are.
Yeah!
It all kind of started as a gag of like, wouldn't it be hilarious if I came out of quarantine with a massive symphonic album? And here we are. Very special. All right, we're gonna carry on now. This is cool. We'll be done.
Oh,
really expensive story earlier. Is there a Dolan in the audience that wants to give me $30,000 so we can play for another 20 minutes? Come on, Venmo me. We're gonna try to get through this. This tune has no preamble. It's called Buddy's Rendezvous.
What's the point being everybody's girl? Maybe you think that way there's no chance getting hurt. Living for no one costs me way more than it's worth. So you're gonna be singing loud me, goddamn. You're as pretty as a postcard. No thanks to the old man. It's the same coat I have on the night that I went. I can stay now, can't it? The streets cool off by then. When can I see you again? Everything you want. What's the fun getting everything you want? I wouldn't know it, but look, maybe you should try. Forget that left issue mom drilled in your mind. Give the world money, save you. Sell his pictures to the press. Buy a place out in the country. Leave this world for someone else. My destruction isn't how I lay. I'm at Buddy's Rendezvous, telling the losers, old times, how good I did with you. They almost believe me too.
Same one. Sound cute. What's there to lose? For a ghost, cheap rent and a suit. Clinging to a rock that is hurtling through space. What's to regret? A speck, made more ridiculous the more serious he gets. Oh, it's easy to forget.
That in 20 years, more or less, this human experiment will reach its final end. I look at you.
beautiful.